Welcome back, Dergs, to yet another drum reaction video. Today, we have for you the legend, the man, as they call him, Mike the Man Mangini. This guy's inspired me for years. I used to watch him in bands such as Annihilator and Steve Vai's band. Absolutely incredible player, phenomenal. Ex-world fastest drummer. I remember following him for the WFD, world's fastest drummer. He won the belt, and he's got everything, this guy. I was very lucky to do a Zoom lesson with him during the COVID lockdowns, and I was kind of blown away by it. I did the polyrhythmic advanced class, and he broke everything down really well so he could digest it and understand everything he was talking about. He gave us exercises to do, which were very helpful. And not only is this guy a phenomenal player, he's also a professor in music, and so it obviously came across really well when he came to teach me, and that's why he was such a great teacher as well. He broke it down musically, he broke it down technically, and he's very good with his rhythm knowledge, with his technicality, with everything. Polyrhythms, technique, playability, musicianship. He's just an absolute monster. He now plays with the band Dream Theater, who have always been quite a favourite band of mine ever since I was maybe about 19, 20 when I first heard about them. And I gradually got into them. Then I was about 22. I really started taking note and realising how amazing this band was. The previous drummer was, of course, Mike Portnoy, who's a completely different type of player, but amazing in his own style as well. But Mike Mangini kind of has taken drumming to a new level, and one could argue is one of, if not the greatest rock players of all time. He can play fast, he can play delicately, he can hit very hard. The size of his sticks are massive. He's got big dynamics, he's got small dynamics. Like I said before, he's good at polyrhythms, and he's got it all. So anyway, without further ado, let's get straight into it, and let's watch Mike Mangini play a drum solo live at Luna Park. You can find this on YouTube. It's not on his channel, so I've had to go to a different channel, so I won't be subscribing or anything like that, because I'm already subscribed to Mike Mangini anyway on his channel. So here we go. Mike Mangini at Luna Park, drum solo. Let's break it down, let's talk about it, and let's get reacting.
Here he is,
everyone. I'm excited. James LaBrie, the singer, introducing him.
The monstrous kit. Mike Mangini!
Look at his face, he's ready. Lovely beat. 5-4. 2-3-4-5. 1-2-3-4-5. 1. See how it's in 5-4? Five quarter notes. Lovely set of triplets in there. The size of his kit's unreal. Bit melodic as well as rhythmic. Multiple notes in each hand, using bounce and fingers. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, carried on. It's all in 5, I believe. Feet against hands, unisons with his cymbals. One, two, three, four, five. That's 5-8, I believe. It's all based around the number 5, as it would be, because it's Mike Mangini. Great with his feet, great with his hands. Nice composition. Lots of different textures around the kit. Beautiful beat there. Double bass pedals. Really nice. Broken rhythms. That's going to be quiet for 2 minutes. Building his tempo up. He knows his rudiments too, obviously. There's all sorts in there. 5-stroke rolls, 6-stroke rolls, doubles, singles. Plays in triplets, plays straight, plays in 5. definitely got his rudiments down. You can hear there between his cymbal and his snare drum, and his feet also. His feet are also doing another rhythm. Triplets between his feet and his hands. Now one hand between his right hand and his foot. Navigation unbelievable. Look at his navigation between the kit. Look how big it is. And he's able to get around it seamlessly. Remember that word, seamlessly. Now he's going into polyrhythms. He was pointing out it's in five with his left hand and his left foot. And then I'm guessing he's going to go straight with his right hand in four. One of the best for polyrhythms. Him and Marco Minman, who I'm going to do a reaction video on, are just unbelievable at polyrhythms. Both trialled for Dream Theatre. Mike Mangini got the job. Syncopated rhythms against each other over a polymetric, over a polymetric time. Just does what he wants. One hand goes on vacation, the other stays at work. Now he's getting his left foot involved doing a new rhythm on the cowbell. That's his left foot. And then just creates a brand new rhythm and beat over with his hands. Just like that. This man's practiced tens of thousands of hours, if not 100,000 hours. Just makes it look easy, doesn't he? Here he goes, he's gonna show off his speed now, I believe. Remember, ex-world's fastest drummer. Second fastest drummer in the world, I believe, to this date. He uses whatever grip he wants. Doesn't have to stay. He can use traditional grip, he can use match grip. He's got it all. Holy! That's quick. That's fast. Unbelievable. Now this is a gravity blast, or a one-handed roll, whatever you want to call it. People overcomplicate things in music. It's just he's doing a roll with one hand. He can do it equally with his left and right. And accenting the cymbal and the bass drum at the same time as the gravity blast. Now this is difficult, and you might not understand what he's doing here if you're not a drummer. But he's going hand against foot. Hand, foot, hand, foot, hand, foot, hand, foot. Singles, together, 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 together. And think about how hard that would be at this tempo. This might sound really easy, or sound just like he's just whacking things, but as a drummer, you understand. This is crazy. That's crazy. It sounds really easy, like he's just going da-da-da-da-da. But that's your hand, foot, and he's actually doing right hand, left hand, right foot. Da-dum, da-dum. Imagine that, doing that over and navigating across the kit perfectly. And then a signature trademark, Mike Mangini finish. Well, that had it all. I can't even begin to explain how much time this man has spent practicing. Not just your rudimentary grooves, not just rudiments themselves, not just accents, not just polyrhythms, not just speed, not just how to write drums in musically along with other musicians, not just technicality or technique. This man has it all. And the last reaction video that I actually did was El Estepario Siberiano. And I thought to myself, how can I even top El Estepario Siberiano's playing? But I mentioned in there, he's the best YouTube drummer in my opinion. But this guy, Mike Mangini, is a lot better. But he's not a YouTube drummer. I mean, he must be in his 50s now. Like I say, he's a professor in music. And I believe, I'm sorry, Mike, if you're watching this, but I believe it was Berkeley, where he was a professor at. And this man is absolutely world class. And I might use that word quite a lot, but I really mean it. He's got everything. If you think about his setup, let's just talk about his setup for a minute. He has unbelievable amounts of toms and cymbals. And the one thing that I'm impressed with the way that Mike Mangini plays, isn't just all the things that I've already listed, it's the navigation around the drum kit. To be able to continue to play notes, continuously alternate notes, from his snare drum straight up above him, but when he was using the different types of percussion, it was seamless. Like, it wasn't like... He's got it down to a T. He's basically got his fingers working so well that he can just keep going and transform it up there. So it's... You don't even notice the change. It would be like me having those toms in front of me and going... Yeah, that's not too bad. When you get quite competent at speed, nowhere near Mike Mangini, however, I don't think I'll ever reach that. But when you get quite competent, you realise how you become more flexible as a drummer to be able to use different components of the drum kit. Because remember, every single part of the drum kit is its own instrument. And so sometimes you get drummers that use a huge drum kit and they don't do much with it. They play... sometimes the odd cymbal over here, the odd cymbal over there, the odd cymbal behind them, and, you know, those extra toms that you get. But Mike Mangini utilises everything. And now, his setup, he's got a kind of a mirrored setup, whereby in the middle, he's got his snare on the top and a snare in the middle. Now, his tom-toms are completely set up so originally. So, usually, you'd have a drum kit. Everyone that I've ever known plays high tom, medium tom, low tom, or if you've got thousands of it, high, a bit lower, a bit lower, a bit lower, medium, a bit lower, low, floor tom, you know, ding, 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 ding. He doesn't play like that. I've never known, if you find somebody that to prove me wrong, then I'm very welcome to it, but I've never known a drummer play where the toms are in a mirrored fashion. So he goes, ding, dong. So there's one there, a bit lower there, then there's his medium, there's his next medium, there's his next medium, his next medium, then his floor, his lower floor, and lower floor, lower floor. So instead of going ding, 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 he's going di, do, 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 do. That's why you see him in the drum solo going, because that's the way his toms are set up. Just to make it a little bit more difficult for him, because like he's not good enough. So I actually think he's doing it through ease, because he's so good with his fingers and his wrists and the way that he plays. I think it's easier for him to be able to go ding 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 ding. I really do, otherwise he wouldn't do it. Now, this guy is one of my favourite drummers of all time, and I'm just blown away by the complexity. By the technique, by his ability to navigate around the drum kit seamlessly, by the way that he plays his dynamics, by the way that he can use a polyrhythm, but most important of all, he's really good at writing parts, and he's really good at playing live, and the most important thing as a drummer, he is accurate. One of the most accurate drummers I've ever watched in my life. It's almost like there's a computer playing, and I always say Mike Mangini is an absolute robot. And that is no disrespect to Mike. If you're watching this, I'm not saying you're a robot because you kind of lack musicality. You have the musicality. He has the musicality. But the point being is, if you can play as a robot drumming and you can be that good, you've nailed it. You've absolutely perfected your art. And he doesn't just do metal, he doesn't just do rock. He can play all sorts, he can play everything. So I've seen him play fusion or something like fusion. I can see the way that he can use his individual independence, as we call it. You get independence exercise in drums, where one thing's doing one thing, one thing's doing the other, because we are multitaskers. But he takes it to a new level. So he can absolutely do all the different genres because of the way that he has been able to practice his independence so successfully. So on that note, I just want to say, I hope I've not missed too much. Oh, one more thing. Look at the size of his sticks. I never mentioned this in the video. The size of his sticks are huge, and that gives him the ability to work his muscles to their maximum potential to be able to make the hits. So when he's exploding with singles, right, left, right, left, right, left, he's hitting every note accurately, and it's going to be hit with force, with power, with loud dynamic. This guy's a monster. And you should go and absolutely check out Mike Mangini. And if you get a chance, book a Zoom lesson with him. He will fill your mind with knowledge. He will further your musical experience. And he will ultimately get you thinking out the box. And you will become a better musician because of it. That's all from me. Thank you very much. Go and check out Mike Mangini. Go and check out Dream Theater. It's been a pleasure to have you on. And I will see you on the next video. Goodbye.